Confession. Confession is good for the soul. Maybe a hackneyed expression, but it is a very true one. Confession at once decreases and devalues anxiety and tension. Confession is as healing medicine to him who has erred. Confess your faults one to another and pray one for another that ye may be healed. The effectual fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. A man should never be ashamed to own he has been in the wrong, which is but saying, in other words, that he is wiser today than he was yesterday. Suppressed sin, like suppressed steam, is dangerous. Confession is the safety valve. Adequate mental readjustment after sin requires readjustment of our relations with our fellow man, see, as well as with God. Adequate mental readjustment after sin requires readjustment of our relations with our fellow man as well as with God. If you harm a friend, it is not enough to apologize to God. You must apologize to your friend as well. Sin is an offense against society as well as against God. And for both offenses, adequate reparation must be made. Confidence. He who has lost confidence can lose nothing more. If I had anything to give people, I would give them confidence. Confidence, see, is the opposite of fear. Confidence imparts a wonderful inspiration to its possessor. Confidence and enthusiasm are the great sales producers. I can do all things through Christ, which strengthens me. The man who believes that this, listen, the man who believes this has calm, quiet confidence, but because his confidence is based upon God's power and not his own power, there's never the slightest speck of egotism. Confidence is that feeling by which the mind embarks in great and honorable courses with a sure hope and trust in itself. No man has a right to expect others to display confidence in him if he has no confidence in himself. Mutual confidence is the pillar of friendship. Skill and confidence are in unconquered army. Confidence is a thing not to be produced by compulsion. Men cannot be forced into trust. Confidence thrives only on honesty, on honor, on the sacredness of obligations, on faithful protection, and on unselfish performance. Without them, it cannot live. Conquer. They conquer who believe they can. He that will conquer must fight. Self-conquest is the greatest of all victories. The real conquerors of the world indeed are not the generals, but the thinkers. Not Genghis Khan or Akbar, Ramses or Alexander, but Confucius and Buddha, Aristotle, Plato, and Christ. Christ being at the top of that list, of course. The honor of the conquest is rated by the difficulty. Though a man go out to battle 1,000 times against 1,000 men, if he conquers himself, he is the greatest conqueror. The only conquest which are permanent and leave no regrets are our conquest over ourselves. I came, I saw, I conquered. Vena vida, vici. Conquer yourself rather than the world. The greatest conqueror is he who overcomes the enemy without a blow. Sometimes you conquer by yielding.